very rainy day today, and there's not much to do. I'm looking out the window right now, and traffic is a bit bad, which is unfortunate. And also, we're getting a new neighbor downstairs, so that's also not good for noise. And also, my last video did not come out well. If you watched it, it's just got something weird with the sound. So I'm hoping, since I charged this battery all morning on my camera, that I won't have it cut off, and I'm hoping that the neighbors moving in won't be too loud, and I have a lot of hopes going on. Anyway, so this is a book I wrote 10 years ago. Hopefully my illustrating ability has improved. I was in college at the time, and I have a terrible picture of myself with a little description underneath that won't show. That's me with kind of orange hair, and I'm holding a sea cucumber. And this was like a little kind of project that I did at my last job, where like we had kids write books and get them published through the library. It was very exciting. And this book is called Gigi. And I actually, so the not so tragic tale of Gigi the Sea Cucumber. I had a friend who's an illustrating, who was an illustration major at the time, and I spoke to her at one point about doing better illustrations for this, because I'm not so talented, but it never happened, so we're stuck with my adorable yet sorely native improvement illustration skills. "I am doomed," gurgled the sea cucumber named Gigi. I had so much fun drawing this. Just like the little pathetic bow that gets bigger as she gets happier, you'll have to take notice of. I'm not a good illustrator, but I enjoy it. She looked slowly around for a sympathetic eye, but the algae floating nearby simply waved with the current like it always did. Very bitter sea cucumber. Picking up her suction cups, Gigi let herself roll down the hill to where a gathering of lobsters were eating. Gulp, gulp, gulp. "I am doomed," announced Gigi to the congregation of lobsters. "Who cares?" the lobsters rudely replied. Now, lobsters in real life are not red, they're more of like a brownish color, but, you know, limited coloring options. Gigi gurgled an exasperated gurgle and slowly suctioned away. Gigi began to cry. She limped on, not particularly caring where she ended up. Soon she came upon a striper fish. "I am doomed," she whined. I wish I had just had some silver to put in there. As the fish was swimming past, he swished his tail abruptly. The striper hit Gigi, causing her to roll out of control down a large hill. Then, whack, she smacked right into a colony of sea cucumbers. "I'm doomed, we're doomed, doomed," all the sea cucumbers were complaining as gloomy as could be. "What's the matter?" asked Gigi. See the bumps kind of going along with her eyebrows there. "We are doomed," the sea cucumbers replied.
"Why?"
Gigi asked again, to no reply. Why are you doomed? We're just doomed, one answered. They were talking just like she did. Oh, it's a surprised Pooh. Gigi was surprised to find out it was no fun to listen to complaining sea cucumber. I may look like you, but inside I am not like you, Gigi declared. I am going to be happy, she thought. The other sea cucumbers looked on in shock as she lifted up her suckers and rolled away. Gigi returned to the place where she saw the striper fish. Hi, she said brightly as she went past. The striper noticed her this time. Gigi passed the congregation of lobsters eating. How you doing? She chortled as she kept rolling. Not too bad. Gigi made it all the way back to her little patch of algae waving in the current. Glad to see you are no longer doomed, the algae said, greeting her. Me too, Gigi replied. And the algae has a face. The end. I probably should put it the end at the end. That is the not so tragic tale. And look at that, I actually completed a video and it didn't go black on me before the end. I used to do all of my noses like this and my eyes. It was pretty fun. I remember having a talk about how maybe it should be a different kind of conclusion. Like maybe there's something more significant than her just deciding to be happy and she's all of a sudden happy. Because, you know, yes, you can just decide to be happy, but it often takes more than just deciding to be happy to be happy. So that is a book I wrote 10 years ago. I still find it delightful. I should write more, you know, and even if it's cut. Poorly constructed illustrations, at least I'll have made something, you know. It's hard to make yourself just do something. I was watching this video that was just posted by a BBC on Facebook about Roald Dahl, and he's just going off to his little hut to write, and I'm like, I wish I had a little hut to write in, because here it's like constant traffic noises and there are a lot of distractions out there, but one of these days I'm planning on getting published, not through a university and not through a library press, and then I'll have a book out there that I can show people and be like, here, buy one. I think that will be fun. Alright, well, I hope you're enjoying your rainy day, if you're having a rainy day like we are. Or the sun, if you are lucky enough, because it's been raining for 2-3 days now. But it's good for productivity. Lots of writing. And NaNoWriMo's coming. So, we'll have fun with that. Alright, bye.